And welcome, everybody here in Twitch chat and everybody on YouTube for some Selesnya Knights. Going to be playing this deck again here in Best of One. We got Puppy. She decided to join us here for a little bit for some Selesnya Knights. Of course, that's her name. This is my dog, Puppy. But yeah, so this is a fan favorite deck, and understandably so. I really like playing this deck. Selesnya is my favorite guild. This deck was originally built for Best of One anyway, with Best of One in mind. And so we've been playing it in Best of Three a good amount, but we're playing it in Best of One today for Best of One Day, Monday. One thing that's really nice about this deck is you get to play four main deck Knight of Autumns, just a really powerful card with all these artifacts and enchantments everywhere in the format. Knight of Autumns is a great card to be playing. We get to play four in the main deck, and we have... And so not only that, but then we also have Acclaimed Contenders, which helps you find them, can dig really deep to find them. Then we got some other tools like Bond of Flourishing and the Great Henge and other things like that that help you go through your deck and find more Knight of Autumns also. But yeah, this deck's basically just kind of like it's a deck that's trying to really get to the late game, go super wide with Worthy Knight, making a bunch of 1-1 humans, get the Great Henge in play, start playing a whole bunch of spells, go wide with Tristani as well, and then use Tristani's ability to pump up your creatures, Circle of Loyalty, also to pump up your creatures, and just kind of attack with a huge battlefield. Sounds like some good magic. So let's get it done. Let's go ahead and play 7 games over in Ranked in Best of One. Why are you so shy, Puppy? Puppy's so camera shy. So camera shy. Yep, the Swiss Autumn Knight. All right, good hint. We got a Swiss Autumn Knight. We'll go get a Plains with the Fabled Passage, of course, with this Cavalier of Dawn. I would not mind my opponent playing a Cavalcade of Calamity. But we're on the draw here, so it's can we stabilize against mono red while we're on the draw? We'll see. Oh, Blossoming Sands comes into play tapped too. I don't know why I was thinking this was Temple Garden. Maybe I should have led with that. This is going to be kind of awkward how I don't get to play Questing Beast on turn 4 now. All right, I should have led with Blossoming Sands. I thought that was Temple Garden for some reason.
I'm happy as a Hellion to start some fires.
Why do you always think?
Say hi to my
Puppy
fiery
acts like
friends.
She's like in trouble or something being in here. She doesn't get to come in this room because Hawkeye's kind of scared of Puppy. So the only time that she gets to come in this room is whenever she's on stream. Good curve here, though. One drop. Steamkin for two drop. Chandra for three drop. That's a great curve.
Say hi to my
yeah, they're making it
friends.
Difficult on us for sure. Untap land. Ugh, got so punished for not playing Blossoming Sands. Because, yeah, if we play Questing Beast, get to kill the Chandra, we'd be doing okay. Yeah, Hawkeye is scared of the pupper, but Hawkeye is also just kind of scared of everything that's besides me. He's scared of everything else. So by making these 4/3s, we are kind of forcing them to use the Slaying Fires there instead of Slaying Fires
fire with fire.
On me. So we're at 8. Castle. If they have a red instant, I'm pretty dead. All right, no red instant. Good. I think we're gonna stabilize. They didn't have that one more instant they needed. Yeah, if I just gain the four life, then the Knight of Autumn's just gonna chump block. They would just be slaying fire on me. So I wouldn't really gain the life, but and then we just chump block. Basically because they had Steamkin. If they don't have Steamkin, I'm probably gaining the life. But because Steamkin can just be a large creature, I want to try to trade with Steamkin. Good job, puppy, we won. We won, puppers. We won. We beat mono red on the draw. Even though I misplayed the first land, we still won. Hello. Well, I wanted to get a green source. I wanted to get a land there, honestly, but at least the Bond of Flourishing cleared out three cards that weren't lands. Yeah, I have two dogs and a cat. Hawkeye's my cat, and then I have two dogs, Harvey and Puppy. Hey, we got the green source. Yeah, either one's good with the Fires deck, 26 or 27 lands. Either one's good. I would say I'd normally play 26, but I guess Cavalier of Flame makes you want to play more lands. Castle Vantress makes you want to play more lands. But yeah, one of those two. No, sub notification's not off. Sinecur, yeah, if you just resub there, maybe try refreshing your stream. There may be like a notification, like something that you have to like send a notification to the channel after you refresh. Check. Take a look at like the chat. I guess I've never really thought about that. Caught. You don't have the cat? I have the cat. Emote. We really need a land here. No, not a land. Really need that land drop, of course. Just like play Tristani to be able to have more blockers and everything, and then also have like 5/5s and stuff. Yeah, puppy's so camera shy. She is never this calm ever. Besides that, there it goes. Good job, Sinecur. Thank you so much. Bring in the hype boats. I'm not sure, does this article may say something about how many lands to play? There's not really a hard and fast rule of play this many lands. Don't play 60 lands. Well, there you go. Yeah, don't. Oh, that's our 16th sub of the day. Yeah, I guess we can. I guess you only have 60 options, right? If you're playing a 60 card deck, so you can start narrowing down the options. It's like, how many lands should we play? Should we play 60? No. Should we play 0? No. How about 59? Nope. Start narrowing it down. No, your question was not rude at all. I haven't really thought about that. If I have any similar traits to my pets, I don't know. Can you make the dog full screen? I don't care about this nerdy game. Puppy, you're so camera shy. Giant killer? Why are they killing giants? That's not cool. Alright, most obvious thing ever. We need to draw a land for Tristani. We at least know the bottom two cards are not lands. So that increases our chances a little bit. This would be a pretty bad time to draw Flourish, as you're like, oh, we're just drawing a Flourish instead of a land. Yeah, I would say, like, the average number of lands for a... Yeah, 24 is a... Yeah, 24 or 25 for a standard deck. Do they got a trick up their sleeve, puppy? I can't really handle no tricks. Even though I'm sure you'd like some treats. Yeah, this is Puppy. She's my dog. One of my two dogs. She's very camera shy. I hope they didn't disconnect. That'd be a bad way for them to lose if they just disconnect. And some juice. There they go. They're back. Puppy, do you have a land dance? Do you have a land dance? We need a land. Ugh, that's not a land. Well, looks like a land wouldn't save us anyway, because the unbreakable formation. Just too many turns and not getting that fifth mana. You know, we just never got it. We had everything in hand cost 5. Yeah, I don't bring Puppy on stream too often because this is Hawkeye's room and Puppy acts like she's in trouble whenever she's on stream here. That's how you act. You act like you're in trouble or something. Because it's best of one day Monday. I'm trying to see. Yeah, this is the day of the week that we play best of one. Because there's a lot of people that like best of one. So we got a day set aside for it. Play best of three the other days. This Robber of the Rich is looking great. My plan, I didn't block because my plan was to play Acclaimed Contender, but obviously we just drew a Questing Beast, so we'll do that instead. Darn. That was my best block against Embercleave. But it was my worst block against Colossus. Oh well. We'll get our stuff back, right, puppy? Robin Hood doesn't win. Spoiler alert. Oh, hey, Horde Means, yeah, hey, GG's. Yeah, you're the mono white opponent from last round. Good games. I just never drew that fifth land. I had, like, everything cost five in my hand, and I just couldn't get that fifth land. It was rough. But Unbreakable Formation is obviously really difficult to beat. But I was sitting on like Tristani and Greathenge since my opener. Ugh. Yep. Yeah, Tristani and Greathenge in my opener. Could have never play them. So need to play that so we have a knight. So now Acclaimed Contender will trigger. All right, puppy. All right, I'll be right back. All right, puppy's back in the living room. Now I got my chair filled with dog hair. Greathenge is pretty good. I really should be drawing my card first and then choosing. But it works out. So yeah, we got all of our creatures back because of Tristani's. That third ability, that passive. All right, we'll just attack. It's like debating, playing a whole bunch of stuff. Which, of course, we could. But we'll just attack. All right, we're 2-1. Yep, I can't do anything about the lag stuff, of course. It's just how it is. This is the last stream with this computer, so it'll be fixed soon. At least, I'm sure hoping so, that the new computer fixes everything. Yeah, I counted it up. We were attacking for exact lethal there, so that's why I just went to attackers. No, I'm still going to be keeping this PC. I won't be throwing it down a mountain. I'm not going to be giving it the office space treatment. This PC does everything else really well except for do the YouTube recording and stuff. Like, if we were just streaming normally and not recording YouTube videos, we wouldn't have this kind of problem, because we didn't before. So yeah, I'll be able to use it as like an extra PC that I could like stream movies and stuff like that on in like an extra room. I was hoping we were gonna draw the land so I could play the Great Henge, but that's not the case. So I'll just trade and play a new questing beast. No, my opponent couldn't block. Yeah, the Cauldron Familiar can't, like, talking about the previous term, the Cauldron Familiar cannot block questing beast because of the second line. If you turn to page 27, article 4, section B, you'll notice that questing beast can't be blocked by creatures with power 2 or less in the novel of rules text that go along with questing beast. Wrinkle so good. Questing book. Yay, land. Questing Beast is so good, it's also Paradise Druid. You just get a... It's a mana creature, too. I discard Cavalier Dawn because it costs 5 mana. And you know I only had the 3 lands after getting rid of the Paradise Druid. Rankle just wrecked me, the second Rankle at least. Oh, right. I didn't quite notice that we're doing the... that's just lethal. I also didn't quite notice that we're doing the discard, but it doesn't matter. That we're doing the sacrifice. All right, so both of our losses were the exact same thing of us having us having 4 mana and not getting a 5th mana when we need the 5th mana to play the Great Henge. So both losses, same thing. Something to note. Yep, need that 5th land again. Okay. Bond of Flourishing. Look for land. Get Temple Garden. It was risky blocking there. It meant that, like, they don't get the counter on the Knight of the Ebon Legion and all that kind of stuff. But obviously that was pretty risky with that block. All right, good. We still drew that fourth land. They have to have an instant here. Maybe it's Bonecrusher Giant? Oh, it's Blacklands Paragon. Hmm. All right. No, the dragon doesn't change colors. Nope. That'd be cool if it did, but it doesn't. Well, why are we playing Cavalier of Dawn? Because it's a knight, so it triggers all of our knight stuff. We can find it with the acclaimed contender. It gives us interaction for different permanents that we don't have very much of without it. You know, it gives us a way to destroy, you know, artifacts, enchantments, planeswalkers, all that kind of stuff. And for how you said that the second line of text is completely lost on this list, that's not accurate. We have Conclave Tribunal. We have the Great Henge. We have Circle of Loyalty. We have 7 artifacts and enchantments that we could put back into our hand. I think my opponent played the Blacklands Paragon after blockers, I think. What? I think that's what happened that last game, but I don't know. Counter on the Knight of Autumn? Counter on the Knight of Autumn. Over here. Nope. Yeah, they may have just been behind and gave up. I don't know. Zagana. No land drop? Going wide. Simic Ramp was in a league. All right, 4-2. We hit our land drops, play our hand, we win. We don't, we get stuck on 4 lands, we lose. So far, we've hit our land drops 4 times, got stuck on lands twice. No, Spyglass doesn't do anything against Lucky Clover. Nope. Alright, so we're ramping into Knight of Autumn. I'd say we're ramping into the Great Henge, but now we got Knight of Autumn. See Bronxong with that resub 6 months now. Welcome back, See Bronxong. Thank you so much for that continued support. It's our 17th sub of the day. Thank you, See Bronxong. All right. Whoa, they took Paradise Druid? Not the Great Henge. Interesting. That's not the best thing to destroy, of course. It does make Doom Foretold a lot worse if their plan is just Doom Foretold here. But the main reason to play that knight, of course, is because of the Acclaimed Contender, where we need the knight in play to be able to trigger Acclaimed Contender. So that was the main reason why I wanted to play Knight of Autumn there. Yep, we're getting stuck on lands. True. I wish I could Conclave Tribunal my own things. So that I could just put something under here, so if they play Doom Foretold, I sack my Conclave Tribunal and I get it back. That'd be nice. I didn't really want to play another creature because this is, of course, Akaya's Wrath deck. And this is not a May. It's not like I can just throw down Conclave Tribunal and then just say, nope, I don't want to exile any of these. We could play more Flower Flourish, absolutely. Could play more Bond of Flourishing. Honestly, I think that's kind of maybe more of the way to go, is more Bond of Flourishing. Where Bond of Flourishings help you hit land drops, but also can just be more of your other cards. The Bond of Flourishing's always looked pretty good. I don't know if I really want like a four of there, but it could see playing upping it to two or three. I went with Tulsimer here because, you know, with a land drawn, we'd be able to play the Great Henge. Well, I mean, the Great Henge is my best card in my deck. So they need two more lands before they go, like, you know, dance for huge amounts. They may just go with the smaller dance here, just to put four things into play, though. Yep. What did they just... What? I guess... I guess they don't want to sacrifice Doom Foretold immediately. Oh, I should have done this. Whoops. I kind of just went to attacks. I should have played this first. Oh, well. I'm not going to just play this turn worse now that I do have this. Yeah, I'm not gonna just like pretend like, oh, I don't have a Tristani. But no, I mean, I could have dealt one more point of damage if I would have done that first.
If you show remorse, I'll show restraint. This might be a bad idea.
That would have been better as a Bond of Flourishing. I'm two lands away from the Great Henge. Like, if we top deck a land, we don't get to play it. There's not a creature that I can draw in my deck that reduces the cost enough to, like, reduce the cost to be able to play the creature plus the Great Henge this next turn with 7 mana. Yeah, Flourish has been a game winner at times. That's true. I don't want to take the Flourish out. I like the Flower Flourish. But I'm not sure if I want to play more though. My opponent played well, had good cards. Played well. They got me. Yes, it's my computer that's lagging. That's why I'm replacing the computer. All right, so there's Selesnya Knights. Went 4-3. Our first two losses were us getting stuck on lands, not getting that fifth land. Even the third loss, we did eventually get all those lands, but we did... You know, we didn't play our fourth land drop, on turn four. We missed a land drop, and it certainly slowed us down. And that bought the control deck enough time to get us. And so, you know, that's the thing. That's the thing about the deck. We got to make sure we hit our land drops. I would like to play, like, one more Bond of Flourishing here, because... I do want one more mana source in this deck. The thing is like what to take out is kind of tough. It could be the second circle of loyalty. That's probably the card to take out. I mean, obviously it could be the third, the Great Henge, because as we saw, sometimes the Great Henge got stuck in our hand. But other times, whenever we, like, if we ever get to play the Great Henge, it's pretty tough for us to lose games once we play the Great Henge. Like, as we were seeing, like, whenever we're actually casting the Great Henge, we're winning. But Circle of Loyalty is the same kind of thing. That's also a difficult card to cast. Hey, Kenobi. Thanks for the Twitch Prime sub. So you say, isn't another flower better? If we only want just the mana source flower, you know, flower costs one to cast, and you always get whatever basic you need. This costs two to cast, and you don't always get a land. So with that, you know, with that being said, flower can certainly be better. But there's other games like where you have four, five, six lands, you know, after a couple of turns, and you really don't want a flower. Like there's definitely gonna be other times where Bond of Flourishing hits us an acclaimed contender that hits us something else, or goes and finds us, you know, any of these, like whatever one of these spells that, you know, we need, like an extra questing beast or anything like that. And of course the three life's not nothing. You know, that three life is certainly valuable as well. I think I would play a second Bond of Flourishing and one flower. But you know, you can try it out yourself. If you're more comfortable with the second flower, that works as well. But I think we'd go down to just the one circle of loyalty. There's definitely times like where we need like to break a board stall, though. Like where we really want the Tristani plus the circle of loyalty to have enough power for our creatures to be able to break a board stall. Hey, Plumber. Thanks for resubbing there. Thank you, Plumber. All right, but that's Selesnya Knight. So those of y'all watching on YouTube, make sure to hit that like button and leave comments over there. I'd appreciate that. But thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you for the next video.